Hello, 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 everybody. What's the derails of valleys? Yeah. Hi there, Burn and Dennis. How you doing? I haven't streamed in a while. I just haven't been awake at the right times, and I don't know. I don't know why. Just didn't feel like it sometimes, too. But yes, finally get back to streaming. And we have two more switching jobs to do. I'm still unloading the train that I ran the last time I streamed, actually. So I still got two more sets of nitrogen to unload. And then we're going to take a passenger train out of here, because there's the other jobs out of here really aren't that great. It's unhooked. Whatever. I tried. I guess I could, I could play some cassette tapes on the boombox instead of my groove music player. But we're gonna be set in a specific genre of music if we do that, play a whole cassette of something. I think I have Final Fantasy VIII music. What are the other cassettes? I'd have to go through them. They're right here in the caboose, though. And then I've got 8-bit 80s music, which does not get copyright flagged, thankfully. At least not the wrong, not, it doesn't get muted anyway. Being lazy and just using the remote now. Oh, is it gonna rain? Looks like that's one of the sets of cars. Yeah, I've had it for a while. It's useless with the steam engine though. But when I'm switching with the diesel, then I use it. I found a Fantasy 14, nice. I've been very tempted of getting into WoW, and I haven't yet, but oh man, it's tempting. And even worse, I'm tempted to actually pay money for it again with, you know, WoW time, so that I can play WoW Classic. Just for the nostalgia type thing, you know? I played WoW for so long. I think WoW Classic might be a bit too far back, though. I don't know, does WoW Classic go up to Burning Crusades now? I think it does. That would be, like, perfect. Well, actually, the most perfect would be if WoW Classic went up to Wrath of Lich King, up to Northrend in level 80. That, for me anyway, that was the pinnacle of WoW. And then they came out with Cataclysm after that, which just ruined everything, really. There were some good things from Cata, and like the new Cata zones were nice, but the game mechanics and all of the stuff that they got rid of to make room for Cata, it's just, it still burns. Cata was, I don't know how many years ago now, Cataclysm, and it still was almost the breaking point for me with WoW. I still played WoW for a while after that, though. But yeah, okay. This is a Derail Valley stream, not a World of Warcraft stream, so I need to stop complaining about World of Warcraft. And at the same time, talking about how I want to play it again. SU-14. That is this one. Okay. So I got this set to unload, and then that set back there to unload that's still hooked up to the steam engine. And then we're done with switching. And I think as far as loads-wise, I'll show you guys all the load cards. But nothing all that super exciting except the passenger train to Goods Factory, so that's probably what I'll do. Well, you know, as horrible as Cataclysm was for me, and once again, not the new areas of Cataclysm, new dungeons so much. Those were actually pretty cool. But all of the game mechanics changes and all of the original content that they got rid of during Cata. But then Mists of Pandaria came out, and yes, Mists of Pandaria, I do think, saved them. If Mists of Pandaria wasn't as good as it was, I think World of Warcraft maybe would have even ended. I really do. But Mists of Pandaria really did bring the game back a lot and brought back a lot of players. And I did like Pandarian stuff. Actually, there's a lot of Pandaria I still never saw, because that was already when I was really starting to not play it as much, but what I've seen of the Panda stuff was actually really nice. It's just the expansion before that is the problem. Cata. I would have loved to see what would have happened maybe if Cataclysm and Pandaria came out without changing everything else with the game that changed. Yeah. Yep, there was a lot of unnecessary hate for Pandaria, yeah. I thought it was pretty cool. Yes, it had the whole Kung Fu Panda tie-in, but so what? They did it great. It did a great job tying that all in, too. the only reason why I was so worried about Pandaria and didn't think it was going to be any good is because Cataclysm just happened, and that was, you know, horrible in a lot of ways. But Pandaria was really nice. Then let's see, after Pandaria was Draenor, which I've never been in any of the Draenor zones, but I like to make fun of Draenor because now we have like a new Shadowmoon Valley and a new, what's the other zone? Terrakar Forest. So it's like, oh, okay, they can't even come up with new places now. They're just, oh yeah, it's a different time period of Outlands before it became fractured in Outlands, which I mean, it does sound like a neat idea, but at the same time, it's like, okay, you guys might be starting to run out of ideas, but I think that expansion is also pretty good, Draenor. By the time Draenor came out, I was already pretty much done with WoW. Actually, I didn't play WoW for like a year or two, and when I logged in, Blizzard just said, oh, you have all these other expansions, and you haven't played in a long time. Here's Draenor, and they just gave me the Draenor expansion. I was like, oh, okay, thanks. But I never really tried it out at all. Like, they added garrisons in Draenor, where you can have like kind of like your own estate almost, I think, and you can have your own like profession trainers, and I don't know what goes on with garrisons. By that time I wasn't playing WoW anymore. Endwalker, is that the newest one? Oh boy. So let's see, there's Draenor, and then after that was the one with the demon hunters, right? I don't even know what that expansion's called. Something. It's not called Burning Crusade. That was when Outlands was new. But it's kind of a throwback to Burning Crusades with the Demon Hunters. So let's see. Pandaria got you from 85 to 90. Draenor to 95? Oh, Endwalker is Final Fantasy 14. Okay. Shadowlands is WoW. Yep. So, yeah, with WoW, there was the expansion with the Demon Hunters, which did look kind of neat. But I was really done with WoW by then. And then there's the one that really makes it all about, like, it was almost like relations between Horde and Alliance were getting a lot better, like, smoother and stuff, and you know, everything wasn't as, I don't know, edgy or whatever. But then the latest expansion, besides Shadowlands, I think it got much more PvP again, right? It turned into a lot more, Horde versus Alliance. And it was like, why are we getting like that? And of course, nowadays with all modern gaming, it's all about PvP. Everybody wants to PvP. That's like the newest craze almost, even though PvP gaming has been around for a while, but it's all about the PUBG and all of the other PvP games, and I hate PvP. I can't PvP for anything. Oh, this whole thing's gone to C1 and dragging my feet here. Battle of Azeroth, that's what it was called. Yep. Legion is Demon Hunt. Okay, thank you, Bird. I'm just kind of talking out of my rear end because I don't remember all these expansions anymore, but there you go. Legion is Demon Hunters. Yep, that makes sense. Battle of Azeroth. Yeah, that's one where everything got super PvP again. Although they got rid of PvP servers. There's no such thing as PvP servers in regular WoW anymore. I saw that. There's like a whole different kind of PvP system where you turn it on or off. You know, it's not as simple as just whether or not you're flagged anymore for PvP. I don't know. More complicated. And now with World of Warcraft, they did the thing where they crunched the, I guess the level numbers were just getting too high. Like, max level was, like, go up to, like, 120. And they must have said, you know what, this is getting ridiculous. The numbers are getting too big. So they crunched it all. Basically, everybody's level was slashed in half. So all of my level 80s are, like, level 40 now or something, you know? Well, they're level 85 and 90, but you know what I mean. Everybody's levels got crunched in half. And the neat thing about that, since I don't even buy WoW time anymore, is all of my level 20 or 21 or 22 characters that were maxed out before for playing on a trial basis, I could play again, because now they're like level 10 or 11. I'm like, hey, neat, I can play them again. Hi there, Olivia, how are you doing? More ridiculous than... Yeah, I figured it was something like that. Yeah, it's so weird looking at stuff where the stats were like plus 100 this or plus 100 that. Now it's like plus 10, and it's like, what? D2, that's Destiny? Yeah. Yeah, I guess it's just inevitable. But the weirdest thing for me when I got on World of Warcraft the last couple of times is I get on my level 10 little character, and there's all these quests telling me, oh, time to go to Cataclysm. And I'm like, no, that's level 80. I'm level 10. I can't go to Cataclysm. I haven't even done, like, Darkshore yet. And it's just, like, it's weird. It's like when you get to level 10, it's like you can go anywhere. It's like, what? Everything scales, you know? And that's a big change. And I can go to, like, the new, Battle of Azeroth zones or something at level 10. And I'm like, what? Level 15, whatever it was. Yeah, one of my characters, I left them where did I leave them now? Oh, the human city, you know what I'm talking about. But, because I had a quest telling me to get on a boat and go to some place I never heard of, and I'm like, but I'm level 10. No. I can't do that. It's just like all the rules got thrown out the window. So, I don't know. Final Fantasy 14. I've heard a lot of good things about it. It's been getting even more popular lately. Which is funny, because it's been around for a long time now. Yeah. Things are wacky. The only thing I don't like with the level scaling, for the most part I like it. I like the freedom of being able to quest pretty much wherever you want. Because that's really what it's like, because everything scales. The only thing I don't like is they did that with the dungeons, too. Like, if you're level 20 and go... Or if you're level 30 and go into Deadmines, everything's level 30. And it's like, but wait, how do I solo the dungeon? And I guess the answer is you don't solo dungeons. Not if everything scales up to you. And, you know, I'm of a dying breed, I guess, of people that play a big MMO where you're supposed to work together with other people and do dungeons together and stuff, but I play, like, on my own. And I'll go into a dungeon once I'm, like, 20 levels past it, and then I can just solo it. It was C1, right? Yeah. Just getting a little worried because... Yeah, I got enough room. But you can't do anything. You can't do that anymore because everything scales. So you have to. You're looking for group nonsense, which is such an annoying thing with the randoms, because everybody just wants to rush through the dungeons, and that annoys me. That's one of the things why I stopped playing WoW, is because. The only way I could do a dungeon, if I wanted to do a dungeon at level, is I'd have to do the looking for group stuff, where it automatically groups you up with people, the randoms. Yeah, I took too long. And everybody just wants to rush through. Speed, speed, speed. I want to get through as many dungeons as possible, blah, blah, blah. And that's just not how I play the game. I'm the opposite. I look around and I'm like, ooh, what's this boss? I'll even look in the little lore book and say, oh, that's what this guy's about. Can't do that. Top two. Banner requires strikes. Good luck, oh boy. Yeah, I believe it. And the really dumb thing when it comes to me and the way I play WoW is I'm usually kind of on my own. Well, I had a few people that I played with all the time, but none of them play anymore either. But I never usually play a DPS character too often. It's almost always, I'm almost always a tank or a healer. And so I should always want to be in a group and do randoms, but I don't. I mean, and of course, when I'm on my own, it's always in some kind of tank spec. And I used to be able to solo dungeons like only like maybe 5 or 10 levels below me, maybe. With a pally, anyway. Pallies are pretty OP. Or at least they could be. But yeah, not anymore. I mean, I guess if you look at it with the right eyes, I could see how it's a good thing that you can't solo stuff anymore, but I don't know. It was the way I always used to play. DPS, yep. Yeah, and if you're DPS, it's hard to get a group, you're right, because a lot of people are DPS, so then you have to get a tank and you have to get a healer, and yeah. I used to play with just a few other people, and it would be one person would be a hunter with a pet, and a lot of times, and then, you know, somebody else that was a DPS, and I was like, pally, I'm a tank pally, but oh, I need to heal too. Actually, a lot of times what we did, if we were trying to do something really difficult, like 3-man, a freaking Wrath of Lich King raid, for example, like Uldum, we'd get like maybe a third of the way through it, some of the bosses. It was fun just to try it. But I would be a healer. I had to, you know, somebody's got to be a full-on healer if you're trying to do a raid. And the hunter's pet would be the tank. And you could spec out a pet to be pretty tanky. But so I had to target the pet all the time and say, okay, he's the tank. Job changes. Yeah. Well, pallies and some other classes in WoW are very versatile, and I could switch around too. But, you know, I guess it just comes down to what you're comfortable with. Oh, that's neat. I've looked at Destiny before. I never actually tried it. And you can do plenty in Destiny without doing PvP, right? Because that's what usually turns me off to a game, is when I find out that it's mostly PvP-based. You'll go for speed. Nice. Oh, good. Good. I like PvE. You know, PvP is so, like, popular and, like, almost the norm nowadays that when I ask if something is PvP, sometimes I'll just get, like, a funny look, like people don't even know what PvP means anymore because they're so used to everything being PvP. If that makes any sense. Let me just make sure all these handbrakes are off. There are PvP. Yeah, well, that's fine. As long as you can get away without doing PvP sometimes. It's just like... And it's like almost every time there's some kind of new game that looks like, oh, that could be kind of like WoW or something. And it's like, oh, nope, it's all PvP. Forget it. Elite Warrior, Dark Knight, Gunbreaker, okay. White Mage, of course. I think I would probably have to be a White Mage if I tried out Final Fantasy XIV. That'd be like pure straight healer, I would think. Monk, Dragoon, neat. And just Breakpoint, Wildlands, Destiny 2, nice. Bard, Machinist, Dancer, Red Mage, nice. Wow, that's a lot. That's a lot more than what WoW offers you, that's for sure. Yeah. That's the thing with PvP, you get ganked up on, and yeah. It's just, oh. You know what I did in WoW for a while, actually, and I don't know, usually I hate PvP, but this was kind of fun. We made Mutant Sage and a new healer and Reaper. Oh, nice. But, me and a few friends at the time, we made up all new characters on a PvP server. Which means that once you're past the first newbie level worlds, newbie level zones, I mean, then PvP is just always on, and everything's a conflicted zone, and at any time you can get jumped by the other faction, right? Usually you have to manually flag yourself for PvP, but not on a PvP server. But for some reason, I guess I wanted just a drastic change. Okay, I didn't start this yet. But I said, you know what, let's make characters on a PvP server. You know, I think it started with one of my friends had a little son who was like only like, I don't know, 10 years old or something. And he was playing on his account, and he's like, oh, I want to do PvP. And so we all jumped over, we're like, okay, let's all make characters on this PvP server. And for some reason, I don't even know why, but I made the stipulation. I'm like, okay, we're going to PvP. We're going to go on this PvP server, but we're going to all make a guild together, and we all have to play female characters. And they went along with it. I don't even know why I did that, but I was like, yes, we all play female characters, and then, you know, we made the guild. We called ourselves Silly Sinister Sisters. I don't know why. It was just something silly. And it started out as just a joke, like we were going to do it once or twice, but then I kept on playing on that server just because it was a new character to play. And then we got a tabard and it was some, like, pink design. And, you know, I have some pretty decent characters on there. I think before the numbers crunch, I think I had a Death Knight at, like, level 71. And, besides that, I had a Pally at level 40-something. A couple of other characters, too. Well, my Druids was just starting Outlands, so that would be, like, level 60-ish. Tashnavanya. She's a, whatchamacallit. Oh, these names used to just roll off my tongue at one time, like the different race names or whatever. She's a Worgen. That's the word I was looking for. Whoa, whoa, whoa. This always happens here for some reason. I don't know why. You hop out of the train, and then you keep sliding along with the train. Oh, this one curve that happens. Anyway, she's a Worgen druid. I love Worgens. You know, all the stuff that I hate about Cataclysm. But the new race they came up with, Worgen, and the new zone, Gilneas, love it. Absolutely love everything about it. playing a bracket above my actual, like, fun. Oh, yeah, that makes sense. Silly Sinister Sisters, yes. I thought it was pretty good. And all the guys that I was playing with, they're like, what are we doing? We're going to what server? I'm like, Lethon. It's a PvP server? I thought you didn't like PvP. I don't, but we're going to do it anyway. Okay. Oh, by the way, you have to make a female character. What? Yeah, it's a requirement. And they went along with it. It was great. And WoW, I have some male characters, but most of my characters are female, not because of any real specific reason, except for, and I know this is not real at all, but if the female characters to me feel faster, just because they're smaller, they're not actually faster at all, I'm sure, but it feels like they are, like, you know, when you're questing around and running around and stuff, you have to do a lot of running around and questing and stuff, and it just feels like you're moving around quicker. Like, the only race that I've never really played much of is Tauren and male Draenei, because they're so huge. you just feel like you're walking through Jell-O all the time. In reality, it's just a visual thing, because in reality, I've ran alongside somebody else who was a Tauren and I was a, you know, something small, and you run next to each other, you're both running at the same speed. You know, it's all a, like, visual mental thing. D3. Oh, that's right here. Maybe we'll get to 10 minutes on this one. The notification didn't work. Oh no. Hold on. We can't have that. Wow, it should have. Hold on. Reload overlays. It should be on the list here. Well, I'm looking at real old ones and I'm just like testing them. Well, I played a notification for you. Thank you for the resub. Thank you for telling me. No, really, I mean it, because I would have never known. I have no idea why it's not actually going through here on Stream Elements. I gotta stream more often. I've been really bad lately. I don't know if I've been kind of in a funk or what. I've been sleeping a lot more than I should be, probably. Some alerts. Sorry, I can't really read this too good. Mute alerts. No. Reload. Huh. Now, what's annoying me with this is it's acting like everything's working fine. Oh, there it goes. Yay! Thank you very much for the resub, Danish. Much appreciated. It finally went through. Yeah. I was worried something was broken, but it's not. It just took a while. One, two, three, so not quite all the way over. Yeah, the remote really makes switching easy. I I don't feel like it's cheating, though, because in real life, you would never only have one person doing both all the switches and hooking up the cars and stuff and driving the train, so I just consider the remote as the engineer. I'm just telling the engineer what to do. All right, bring us back 10 cars. Okay, 10-4. That's what the remote is. Someday multiplayer will happen. It's gonna be years from now, I think, but someday. Actually, there is a multiplayer mod. But it's, from what I can gather, it's very buggy so far. Like, they've been working on it, and I think the guy hasn't worked on it now for a while, but supposedly it still works. Somebody was just asking in the Discord if anybody wanted to do it today. And it kind of works, but the biggest thing is the only engine you can use in multiplayer is this one, the little switcher. Which, I mean, is okay. And, of course, you can do a multiple unit and link up a few of them, so you can still do a big train, I would think. But still, apparently, it's pretty buggy. Like, the cars won't sync up between the two players, and then every once in a while, some of the cars will just go flying in the air because one car spawned on top of another or something wacky like that. So it needs a lot of work still, the multiplayer mod. And I'm guessing that you can't really have any other mods going if you're doing the multiplayer thing. Or maybe you can, but everybody's got to have the same mods. I don't know. I'm probably never going to try it just because I'm already running so many other mods. I'd have to take off all the mods that I'm running right now, probably start a new save. I don't think it's really worth it yet. Not until all the bugs are ironed out. But speaking of a game having a multiplayer that hasn't before, what I am getting very excited about, but the same kind of problem applies with the whole mods, is, yeah, American Truck Sim. Now, there's a 1.41 beta of American Truck Sim out. And there's a convoy option, straight from SCS, where up to 8 people can play multiplayer. And there you go, Olivia says that it works well. I've seen some people playing it already. I'm gonna try it out eventually. Yeah. It's really neat because it's multiplayer and there's still AI traffic, which is what the ATS-MP mod really misses out on. Is usually, unless you're in a convoy, the roads are dead. It depends on the server and which game. The ATS multiplayer is never dead. There's so many people driving. But still, it's not having AI is weird. The DLC has to be identical. You have to be matched, right? Yeah, well, I have all the states. But I don't have some of the small DLC stuff, like the different, like the newest one that I've seen Jeff play with the Goodyear skins and a couple other little things, maybe like a steering wheel mods or, well, not mods, but DLC. And I don't have the special cargo one. That's the big one that I'm missing. Hold on a minute. Oh, I forgot a bag and I didn't see it. Probably thought it was empty. Oh, special cargo. Yeah, I guess that makes sense. Special cargo would be really tricky in convoy. Because of the escort car in the front and back, the AI escort cars. Trailers and states have to be identical, yeah. I'll try it out eventually. Sorry, I'm just messaging my mother on Facebook. Apparently I missed one of the grocery bags. Oops. Kind of cold outside anyway today. Pretty crazy, actually. What is this? We're at the end of May. And last night, the wind chill got down to like, or feels like temperature. They don't call it wind chill anymore. They call it feels like, but it's the same thing. But it got down to like lower 40s. And you could feel it too. It was getting pretty cold because our house is all in summer mode. So I've got all the storm windows down, or all the storm windows up and the screens down. And, you know, we close the windows, but still, without those storm windows down, they're pretty drafty. And my bedroom, my mom's bedroom, and even downstairs, we got all the air conditioners in. And you don't seal those up for wintertime temperatures, so, yeah, it got pretty cool and drafty. And then this morning, I even turned on the heat for a little while. It's like, oh my god, we're turning on the heat and it's almost June. Of course, it only ran a couple of times for a few minutes, but still. Okay, am I done with switching? I do believe I am. Machine factory. Oh yeah, it's an old house built in the early 20s. So yeah, I think I'm just going to not even worry about all those other small jobs to put together. I'm just going to take this passenger train to Goods Factory in town, because I'm pretty sure, let's check it out, but I'm pretty sure there's plenty of water still in the steam engine. I'll track the steam engine on. Why am I looking at these gauges? I know it's been shut down for a while. Oh, I know what I was going to do. I was going to make sure there's water in it first. Yeah, there is. And... oh, yeah, we're only a couple of bars down. Yep, we got plenty of water. So we can take that passenger train to Goods Factory pretty easy. All right. It's just got to turn around on the turntable. I think I'm going to be cheap, keep it shut down for now, and grab it with the switcher. Shove it on a turntable and spin it around. I'll accept it, yeah. PE32. Why did I come here? I don't know. I'm not going to start the freaking job yet, that's for sure. Brain. Okay. So now I gotta grab the steam engine, spin it around. Yeah, this house is pretty old. There is zero insulation. And the windows are really old, you know, double hung windows, and most of the windows, the sash cords are broken, so you gotta get a stick to prop the window open with so it doesn't just slam back closed. You know. I still like old houses better though. It's got character. Actually, this house doesn't have a whole lot of character. The house we used to live in was even older, and that did have a lot of character. Yeah. But like the wall studs and the floor joists, you know, nowadays, or any kind of modern building houses and stuff, and by modern I mean, I don't know, 1960s or 70s or newer. Everything's standardized, like the studs have to be 16 inches on center, and I think that's the same for the floor joists too. This was built before that, and like the floor joists are like 20 inches on center. There's pretty big gaps between the floor joists. And then when they put the floorboards down, they're, you know, thin pine boards. There's no subfloor, no such thing as plywood back then. It's just floorboards laid down on joists. But they didn't even bother to make the ends of the floorboard line up on a floor joist. So half the time the ends of the boards are just floating between the joists. Which you can get away with in the beginning because they're tongue and groove floorboards, so they all lock together and whatnot. But when everything gets old and the wood starts shrinking and stuff, then anywhere where there's one of those joints where the joists, where the floorboards aren't lined up on the joists, the end of the boards will bounce. In the case of my bathroom, the end of the floorboard is like maybe a quarter inch lower than it should be. So there's like these vinyl peel and stick tiles that were laid down just on top of the floorboards, which was wrong. They should have put down plywood first, because this was done relatively recently, like, I don't know, 10, 15 years ago or so. But now the vinyl tiles, there's a big chunk of one of them that cracked out and broke out because it's, you know, so uneven. And I'm gonna fix that eventually. It's just money, you know. Just buy a pack of peel and stick vinyl floorboards and scrape up the old ones. Where am I going now? I'm getting the... Oh, actually. Did I do that in time? Yeah, we're tracking right. I gotta get around to the other end. Not sure if I had an empty track. I might have had an... I had an empty track. Oh. But yeah, I gotta scrape up the old tiles and get some kind of filler material and fill it in so that it's back up level. Because the floor... The board doesn't actually bounce up and down. Somebody did put like a piece of wood under that end of the board from underneath to support it, but it's just not quite high enough. But I just gotta fill that in with something and then put some new tiles down. Baltimore and Ohio. Oh, okay. I gotta repaint the engine and caboose. Getting dark already. Yeah, it's 6:30 almost. Yeah. That's good. It's always good. Haha. Yeah, I can see that makes sense. That is nice. Ah. I'm not quite as good at fixing things as I was, and I don't have anybody to really help me fix things anymore either. So, yeah, I could see the benefits of that. There's always something to fix in this house, definitely. And a lot of times it's something that I can't fix and that we can't afford to do anything about it, so it becomes a problem. A couple years ago, the top part of the chimney in this house, because it's an old house, goes up. Well, it did go up pretty high, past the part of the roof that, you know, there's the roof, and then it went up like extra four and a half feet past that. Well, this chimney, it's a decent sized chimney. Anytime you looked at it, and this was as long as I can remember, oh yeah, brick, and painted gray for some reason. It was always painted gray. But this chimney always had a lean to it. It always leaned back. And it was just always like that, so we just said, well, that's just the way it is. And my grandparents did have it repointed and stuff at one time. Because they've had this house since 1957 when my mom was born. But, a few years, well, maybe a year before, a few years ago, if that makes any sense, we had some guys do some work up on the roof, because it's an old roof, so we were worried, nothing's leaking with it yet, knock on wood, but it is an old roof. And, he noticed some issues with a few loose shingles and stuff like that. So he went up there and he did a little bit of flashing roof. He did work and did a little bit of roofing work. And he worked on that chimney a bit. He, like, I don't know what he did with it, really. But he did work on it. I think he painted some waterproof paint on it. He did more than paint it, though. I think he added some mortar and stuff to it, too. I was like, oh, okay, well, you know, you didn't charge much, and it was peace of mind. It was like a little bit of peace of mind. It was like, okay, we've done a little bit of maintenance on the roof. That's always good. So then a year after that, we had a wacky spring where it was like just one week it was in the 20s still cold, and then the next week it was up in the 50s and 60s, you know, it was back and forth, cold, warm, cold, warm. And one day, I wasn't home to witness this, I was out with my mom for a change, and one day the chimney just fell over. The whole thing fell over. It fell over backwards onto the lower roof over the kitchen, broke into two big chunks, and one chunk went down on the roof, and then the other chunk fell on top of it, shoving it through the roof. And somehow the ceiling joists managed to catch it and keep it from going all the way through into the kitchen, the chimney. So, yeah, oops. I think part of the problem, I mean, that chimney was always kind of messed up. We always joked that somebody was drunk when they built that part of the house. But I think part of the problem was when the guy sealed up the chimney more, like he tried to seal the flashing more and stuff, he probably made it so that the moisture that would get into the mortar couldn't get back out. Like it was sealed in. You know, it needs to breathe a certain amount, I would think. Oh, I didn't have to go up this far, did I? It's freaking dark. So I think it was sealed in a little bit too much. Wait a minute. That is turned. Yeah, I went too far. Sorry, I'm confusing myself. Oh, wait, no. I don't want to... I'm going to the turntable. There. So it was sealed in a little bit too much, I think. And so the water, instead of escaping, was sealed in. And then with the expansion contraction, it just froze and thawed and froze and thawed, and then the whole thing just fell right over. Yeah, pie chimney. And, yeah, that was a pretty big repair that we didn't... I mean, homeowner's insurance kind of covered it. Oh, we're going for it now, right? I think homeowner's insurance would cover the cost of replacing or rebuilding the chimney, because that was just like wear and tear, old age wear and tear. But they covered the cost of the hole in the kitchen roof. It basically, they didn't cause... they didn't cover the cost of replacing the chimney, but they covered the cost of what damage it caused. And we showed them some cracks inside the house, too. In the drywall, but don't tell them, but those cracks were already there. Yeah, I'm going the right way. And, I think they looked in the basement and they saw that some of the wood posts weren't that great, but we already had steel jack posts in, so I don't think they covered much with that, but anyway, we found a handyman that was pretty decent that would, he came up and he went up in there and he was able to clear out all the bricks and patch up the roof. But the actual chimney didn't get fixed for years after that. We just had like a tarp around the sides of it. And it was okay. The roof never leaked or anything, but we were kind of playing with fire. Eventually the neighbors found somebody to fix it and helped us with the cost. Teammates and Breakpoint, but you just have no interest in that. I haven't had a whole lot of interest in gaming in general lately, and that's kind of part of the reason why I haven't been streaming. Also, that's not the only reason. Between my erratic sleep schedule, and I've just been sleeping a lot lately for some reason, and also my nephew Jordan lately has been really active with wanting to play games with me lately, which is neat. I do like playing with them, but it was kind of out of nowhere. I wasn't expecting it, really. And we were playing Minecraft. I made up a server just for him, and he wanted, for some reason, don't ask me why, but he wanted to have a hardcore Minecraft server. And I was like, okay, you know, hardcore means that you die once and it's all over, right? But of course he's got a way around that. You can go into spectator mode and then press like F3 plus N and then it respawns you. He said, oh, I have, it's okay, I'll just have 3 lives. Well, he's died probably 5 or 6 times by now, but what am I going to do? Tell him, nope, you can't respawn anymore, I'm going to delete the world. No, I'm not going to do that. Whatever, we'll keep playing. It should have never been in hardcore in the first place. But, so we've been playing that a while, and then lately, for some reason, Minecraft hasn't been working for them. I don't know. It's hard to try to do technical support with a little kid that doesn't know a whole lot about computers. And then my sister, whose computer it is, she doesn't get on it much anymore. And then they have this new dog. And if she's in the room with the computer, the dog freaks out, apparently. I don't know. Her house is a freaking zoo. I love animals, but man, She's gone all in on the animal front. But anyway, what she told me is that Minecraft doesn't work because somebody playing Minecraft got hacked. And, like, I don't know the details, and then so because of that, they made nobody's Minecraft work, and I'm like, alright, that's BS, but I'm not going to get into some kind of argument with her. So whatever, Minecraft is broken because somebody got hacked somewhere else. You know, all of Georgia can't play Minecraft, okay, sure. Whatever. I don't try to do technical support with them. But anyway, so he talked her into buying me a copy of this game called Raft, because he already played it for a while and he really likes it. And it is pretty neat. You do some crafting, but you know, you just start off on a raft and you fish up bits and pieces and build onto the raft. I could stream it someday. I could make another world and stream it someday. Hey there, Sturgy. But He's been really wanting to play Raft a lot lately, so I've been playing that with him for a few days. And then last time we played it, maybe a couple of days ago, we played it for like an hour or so. It was really early in the morning anyway. And he's like, oh, I'm not going to play anymore. I'm bored. I'm like, okay. And then we haven't played. Although, he's not always at his mother's house either, so that's probably why we haven't played with him. But that's another reason why I haven't streamed much, though. Because I've been playing a lot with him, and I'm not going to stream playing a game with him. He's too young to be on a stream, I think. And also, the way I play games with him is I just kind of let him do whatever he wants and just go along with it. And I'm like, oh, wow, what's that redstone? I never saw a redstone before. You know, I haven't been playing Minecraft for 10 years. Oh, what's that, a villager? You can trade with them? Wow! Yeah, stuff like that. Oh, hi, Sturgy. Oh, you resubbed. Thank you very much. Yeah. I think it will come through eventually. Oh, you know what? I'm looking. Yeah, there's Dennis's one. I think it will come through. Give it a little time. Thank you for telling me. Thank you for the resub. Yeah, finally I stream. I know. I haven't done it much. Okay, where are we putting this? PE32. Yes, so I'll stick it on this track. Okay. Oh, and the caboose is... Where's the caboose? The caboose is on the wrong end, isn't it? Caboose I'll leave on the loading track, I think. Okay. So, yeah, we'll just ride on the plow for now. The switcher? The remote you're talking about that I'm holding? That's controlling the switch engine, the 44-tonner. Pretty soon I'm not going to be using it anymore because I'm going to switch to Steam. It's just going to be fun in the dark. It's not really a 44-tonner, I just call it that because I used to work on one. Well, it's like the European version of a 44-tonner. You still got your Jeep? Olivia? I wish I still had my Jeep. Ah, that's not good. My Jeep had some issues, but I still loved it. The frame was kind of rotting out, though, back in the corner by the shock mount. Oof. Hey, the good thing is you know how to fix it. Sucks. That really freaking sucks. I think the Jeep. Yikes. I think if I remember with my Jeep, the last time it got tires, and it could have been already like this, I don't remember because it was mom that got it, but like two or three of the lug studs on two different wheels were broken off, so they had to weld in new lug studs. No, they didn't have to weld. Those are replaceable, right? I don't remember. It was kind of a big deal, though. It didn't cost much, though. We go to this tire discount place downtown, and they're just really good. Like, if you got a tire that's leaking air and it just needs a patch or something, it'll be like $10. Or if it was a really easy patch, they'll even tell you, "Oh, that we're not gonna charge you anything. That was easy." And then you just, you know, you give the guy $10 or $20 anyway, because they're just that cool. I don't know what they had to go through. Somehow, a bunch of the lug studs got broken. Oh, God. Oh, yeah, if the sidewalls are bad, then yep. Yep, that's gonzo at that point. Oh, this is the ending theme, isn't it? That takes too long. Oh, I don't want to listen to Eyes on Me. Wait a minute. Are we not on shuffle? Are we stuck? Shuffle. Okay, now we're getting other thing. Sorry about that. I don't really pay enough attention to the music. Oh, Baltimore and Ohio. Right, I have to change this just for aesthetics. Where am I going? Oh, right, I just dropped off the steam engine. Yeah. Sidewalls are cracked, that's what dry rot at that point, right? My Jeep, this is a while ago, the leaf springs were so worn out, instead of making a smiley face, they made a sad face. I said, well, if I need leaf springs anyway, I might as well put in a lift kit, you know, place all four springs and shocks. Really didn't cost that much. But the funny thing was, my friends were trying to get me to get, like, the 3-inch lifts. I was kind of torn between 1.5-inch and 3-inch lift. They were like, oh, get the 3-inch. It's not even much more expensive. I was like, well, with the 3-inch, I also have to add body spacers, and I know how rusty this freaking Jeep is. And it was saying something about the angle with the steering column might get messed up. And I'm like, oh, no. This looks like too much other crap. That, and I didn't want it to be really high. Everybody, oh, you can get 3 inches and then you can get bigger tires and you can do this and that. And I'm like, listen, I'm getting a lift kit because I need to replace suspension pieces anyway. I'm not trying to make this into some super off-roading Jeep thing. Yeah, body lift. I think the three inch suspension lift, I think, included spacers to bump the body up a little bit too. I was like, I don't want to do that much, so I went with the 1.5-inch lift kit. And they're like, oh, you pansy. I'm like, listen, it's good enough for me. Right? Yeah, that's a huge change. So anyway. Because the old leaf springs were so bad, they were literally looked like this. I only put in a 1.5-inch lift kit, but it raised that thing probably pretty close to 3 inches. Because, you know, the new ones obviously were curved the right way. And when it was all done, my friend Bobby would go put his hand under between in the gap between the tire and the wheel well, and he's like, holy crap, how much did you lift this thing? And I'm like, 1.5 inches. Oh yeah, that makes sense. That makes a lot of sense. Yeah, and boy, that job, that replacing the shocks and springs for me, that should not have been too big of a job. And I mean, technically it wasn't that hard, but every single bolt I had to turn was rusted solid. I mean, well, no, not rusted solid. You could get a socket on it, or the stupid star head things that I had to buy for the Torx heads. But it was just so hard to work every single bolt. And I broke a lot of tools doing it. It took me a week to do that job on that truck. But it was kind of fun doing all that work. I remember having a breaker bar with a freaking 4-foot long piece of PVP pipe, like 2-inch PVP pipe, on the end of the breaker bar, and you're just sitting on the ground just pulling it like you're rowing a boat. And for the bolts in the center of the leaf springs, I guess they call them the U-bolts, the bolts that attach the leaf springs to the axles. But God, I probably spent a day just trying to get like 2 of the 4 sets of U-bolts loosened. It was ridiculous. No, I was supposed to leave that. I gotta leave this on the loading track, because it was on the wrong end, you see. Hi there, scissors, how you doing? It is indeed pink, yes. What? I just stirred you. The 8-ball lies. Lies and slander. Well, not really slander, but lies anyway. Actually, I think I will. Yeah, I'll put the caboose in front of the. Yes, this. I know what I'm doing. I'll put the caboose in front of the engine, and then I can just tack it on with the engine, the steam engine. That makes more sense than trying to back up 4 or 5 cars into the caboose in the dark with no remote. Yeah. It's so easy to get distracted in this game and then do something stupid, like, I don't know, run the caboose into the steam engine too fast. I caught it in time and slowed down in time, but there's a cat under my bed over there and making a ruckus. And I was like, what's going on over there? And then I looked back and I'm like, oh, there's the steam engine. But it's fine. It's fine. We averted disaster. Okay, this thing is still in Pensy. We need Baltimore and Ohio. I think I made it Baltimore and Ohio. Yeah, there. That's Baltimore and Ohio. Can't actually put writing on the sides of the caboose yet because it gets mirror imaged on the other side. Hold on, I missed some of Olivia's messages. Not just raw lift, so it keeps all angles within spec. Yeah, that's a big thing with lift kits, is if you do a big lift kit and you don't know what you're doing, and then the angle of, like, the steering shaft and other, like, U-joints and stuff get all messed up. Even with mine, I only did 1.5 inches to lift, and I had to take a freaking saw to the metal floor so that I could get the shifter to go into reverse. I had to just shave away at it a little bit, the hole for the shifter. I'm sure there was probably something that I could have done, like, with the transmission mounts or something to tilt it back forward a bit. But no, I had to take it to cut away at that. And even after I did that, I was afraid to do too much. Actually, no. If I wanted to do it right, I needed to take the saw and cut a little notch in, but I never did. So it would go in reverse, but you had to hold the shifter in reverse. Like, if you didn't hold it all the way, it would grind, and you had to hold it or else it would pop out. But, I mean, it's reverse. It's not that big a deal. But, yeah. Now, that was only an inch and a half lift. So, yeah, you gotta know what you're doing. Oh, yeah, I was looking through the comments. No rock crawler, yeah. No rock crawler. You just want to get the bigger wheels and tires in and stuff. So that's B&O. I need the steam engine to be B&O. B&O President. Yes. Switch. Oops. So used to usually letting the air out. This time I didn't really want to. Oh, wait a minute. I'm keeping the freaking caboose here. Brain. But yeah. Okay, I am done with the switcher now. Well, I've got the brake on in the engine so I can bottle the air. The caboose is still here, so I can get the shovel later. Okay. Fine. I just gotta bring the boom box here back with me. We might play some cassettes instead of the groove music player. We'll see. Ooh, cracked tooth, not good. The cable. Oh boy. Oh, that's not good. I mean, it's good that it stopped hurting, but you still better get yourself to a dentist. Because eventually it's going to get infected and then it's going to be worst pain on earth. Trust me, I've been down that road a couple times. Yeah, that's not good. Unless that tooth already had a root canal, which I doubt it did, then that needs to get fixed soon. That's good at least. But it ain't gonna last too long. Alright. We'll go through C yard, it's fine. I swear it'll definitely make it hurt if it's gonna hurt. Yeah, well, it's good for now, but eventually that layer that's protecting the root is gonna go away. How urgent the care, yeah. Oof. I've gone through a lot of issues with bad teeth, and oh, it sucks so much. It just really sucks. The last one I had pulled was a molar, and it could have been saved. It had a hole in it, but it could have been saved with a root canal, but my insurance, for some reason, only covers root canals. On the front teeth. It doesn't cover root canals on the back teeth. Doesn't make much sense to anybody, but that's what the insurance says. It'll do a root canal in the front, and in fact, they want to do root canals on all of my front top teeth, which I gotta do sometime. I think they wanted to do it not too long after I had that molar pulled, and I was like, no, I need to recover from that. But eventually I am gonna have to have more root canals. Well, not more. This was the first root canals I've ever had, but yeah. I don't know. Of course, my teeth are this bad because I've been so, like, terrified of the dentist and everything that I, you know, brush my teeth, but I never really went there to get regular cleanings or anything else, so, and they just got bad and worse and worse. It's partially genetics, too, I think. Some people barely even touch their teeth and they're fine their whole life. Yellow is my tooth color of choice. Once again, yeah, sure, you'd think I'd smoke. Yep, soda. That's what destroys. That's what destroys teeth. Yep. I drank a lot of soda too. I still do, but I drink diet soda. But it's still soda. It's still like acid, I guess. I try to not drink as much. I don't drink nearly as much soda as I used to. Diet is even worse. Yeah, I believe it. I believe it. Aspartame. Yeah. Right. I mean, it's just... Alright, Dinesh, good night. Nice to see you come around. I'll try to stream more. I think daytime really is the best time for me to stream too, so I think my sleep schedule's spinning back around, so it'll work out. Coffee? Yeah, coffee might stain it more, but it might not destroy them as much. That makes sense, actually. Yeah. A lot of people don't like coffee because it stains their teeth, and it's like, well, staining I can deal with. Does it eat away at your teeth? That's the question. Just grab this or else I'm gonna forget it. Half tank. Right, yeah, not unless you just load it with sugar. That makes sense. I never liked coffee, or tea for that matter. Yeah, I never used any sand. Or hot drinks in general, really. I guess I used to like hot chocolate. $600, not bad for how much switching we did. Yeah, alright. Oh, we got our... Oh, where did you put my boombox? Of course. Doesn't matter. Turn this thing off. Alright. Let me throw some switches back. I'm gonna be lazy and leave the switcher there because it'll despawn after a couple hours anyway. That's the wrong button. Okay, we're good. Alright, I went around the other way. Okay. Okay, we all should be all set on that then. Time to fire up the old steamer. Time to get the old shovel. Can't fire up the steam engine without coal. No, 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 we're not going to phase through the door. We're going to open the door like a gentleman. Just close, thank you. Hate toothpaste, yeah, I kind of don't like it much either. Coffee, ice cream, don't like coffee in general. Hey, same thing. I do like coffee flavored stuff sometimes. I'm not a huge fan of it, but I kind of like it. Now, even though I could turn on the locomotive lights right now, I'm going to RP it as I can't turn on the locomotive lights yet. Because we have no steam, and with no steam, you're not going to be turning the generator that works the lights, right? Right. Well, we'll say that. I think they changed the texture on the coal. I think it looks better. Interesting. I could just be crazy, but I think it looks a little different. This is kind of silly the way you just take the lighter and throw it in. What's the throw button? There. And then you just magically have the lighter back in your hand again. Okay. What it should be is you should have to grab, like, I don't know, a piece of wood or some kind of kindling, light that, throw that into the fire. I don't know why I decided to close the door by hand that time. Alright, now we wait. Look at that, steam's already starting to build up. Of course, this isn't very realistic. The steam should take probably at least twice as long to build up even more. But nobody wants to sit around and wait, like, forever. So that makes sense. So first thing we gotta do is go backwards and tack the caboose onto the end of this set of cars. Okay. I could go through the tapes, the cassette tapes, actually. Let's do that while it's warming up. Welcome back, Sturgy. Caboose is this way, thank you very much. Now here's the thing. You can't... What is that? Playlist number 7, huh? You can't really label any of these cassettes. Oh, this isn't the table I thought it was. Well, so, and I didn't write it down, so I kind of don't remember what each each cassette is. So this is playlist 7. That, I think, is one of the newest ones. Oh, I have some cassettes in here. Playlist 2. I think 1 and 2. 1. I think 1 and 2 are the Final Fantasy 8 discs. Maybe even 3, too. The other fancier looking ones, like these are the built-in playlists that came with the game. I think 8 through 10 are probably still blank. I bought the cassettes so I could have them, but they're still blank. Yeah, these are like pre-made ones. You can if I put this one in. Alright, I gotta stop my music now. Oh, it's, maybe, Red Bear, you should turn it on first. Oh, no, 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 no. I can't play the radio, that's copyrighted. Retro rock theme. Oh, you know what? We'll play. We'll take that with us. 1, 2, 3, 4. I think any of the built-in cassettes are probably going to be safe to play on stream. I don't have to worry about copyrights with them. Oh, this is C64 music. Okay, we'll take that. This is such a neat mechanic they added to this game, in all honesty. This boombox. I mean, sure, I could just use the Groove Music Player and just play my own playlist. 1 and 2 is Final Fantasy VIII, I think. Where's 3? There's someone here. Oh yeah, here's the rest. Three. But it's just so cool that you can make your own like cassette tapes. So on 5. Oh, Sonic music. I've gotta go fast. Well, the steam engine goes fast, so that fits. Okay. I think 6. Put him here. Yeah, I know, I'm just wasting. No, don't fall out of the drawer. It's kind of buggy. But I still like it. Okay. Oh, I have to shovel more coal in by now. Oh, we got steam. All right, turn the lights on. Now, with the newest locomotive lights update, they changed it. It was that you hit this button to turn on the lights, and then whether you were in forward or reverse, that controlled which headlight would be on, front or back. But they just recently changed it, and I love this change because this lever is here anyway. Now, when you put the lever forward, that gives you the headlight. And when you put it back, all the way down, that gives you the backlight. And that's such a huge change because now, if you want, while you're driving backwards, you can still have the light facing forwards. Which usually you wouldn't want to do, but sometimes maybe with switching that would come in handy. Of course, the downside is when you want to switch the light from front to back, you have to run over here manually and change it. But that fits the steam engine pretty good because the steam engine, you have to do everything manually anyway. Although now what I'm noticing, I'm panicking a little bit, is the gauges aren't lit up. Why aren't the gauges lit up? Does the button still light up the gauges? Oh, the button lights up the gauges. Okay. I think the way it should work, and we won't really see this until Derail Valley actually adds the headlights as a working thing, is I think probably this lever would denote forward or back, and the button would actually turn the lights on and off. But the way this is working out is that the lever is turning the lights on forward or back, and the button turns the interior light on and off, which is great. That also means that during the day, I can still have the gauges lit up, but I can turn off the headlight. That's cool. I like that a lot. Okay, the water is all the way down. And we've got a full head of steam, but we need more coal. Okay, good. Wooden roof. The inside. The ceiling has wood panels, yeah. It's metal on the top, though. Oh, let me sort out the boombox now. Where's the boombox? I didn't put it down yet. I didn't. There we go, we got music again. Gotta go fast! Just put the tapes next to the boombox, I guess. Of course, it's not like the tapes are gonna stay standing up like that, but they'll stay next to the boombox. Oh my god, how many tapes did I bring? There we go. Okay, we set now? Yes. Okay. I never set the handbrake on the caboose, right? Now the air is hooked up. Handbrake, it's on the other end. I'm pretty sure I never did. No, I didn't. Okay, good. And of course, with the boombox, you can walk away from it and get back, and the music comes and goes. I mean, that's pretty neat, right? I think so. Does Red Bear remember how to run the steam engine? I think he does. Well, the main danger with this passenger train is the damn thing is way too light. Lightweight. Like, I could pull it with the frickin' switcher if I wanted to. So I'm gonna go too fast, maybe. Like, working out of the food factory here, the speed limit's 30. And it's gonna be easy. Even going uphill, it's gonna be easy to go too fast. I like that. I love that manual headlight. We're going through Sonic 1. We're up to Marble Zone. Oh, yeah, Labyrinth used. When they first designed Sonic 1, they were going to have Labyrinth Zone as the second zone of the game, and then they realized, wait, this is way too hard. No. But the music track list is still in that order. I can't see, but we're going really slow, so it's okay. You gonna make it? You gonna make it? If I was in a rush, I would just go in the engine and give it a couple more puffs. No, not gonna make it. Okay, it must be uphill. thought it was just coasted in, but nope. Wait a minute, isn't this Scrap Brain already? Okay, the tracks are not in order. Listen, I know my Sonic music. Never even had Sonic back in the day, either. Never had a Sega. But I still really like Sonic. I'm just gonna make sure all the handbrakes are off by doing the kind of cheaty thing. Well, it's not cheaty, it comes with the handbrake mod, but you can hold shift and hit the independent brake release button, and it'll release all of the handbrakes with shift. Without shift, it just releases the one. I should probably have my little flashlight on, but whatever. I know what I'm doing. Okay, I just gotta get around to the other end of the train. Now, of course, as always, the passenger cars are really easy to derail, so you gotta be really careful with your speed when you're dealing with curves and switches. Like, in this yard, going through all the switches, I wouldn't go much faster than 20. And then leaving the yard out on the main is a 30 zone with a pretty tight turn. So, probably a little under 30 for that. But when you're not worried about switches, curves, then you can really open her up and go fast pretty quick. If that makes sense. My temperature's pretty low. I should put some coal in, but we got her maxed out at steam, so since we're just moving the engine around, I'm not gonna put coal in just yet. The more water you conserve, the better, because there's not many places you can get the water. I do have the double capacity mod for the tender, because in my opinion, having a steam engine and having half of the cities not have coal and water for it is just a silly decision on the part of the devs. I think they'll change that when they add the new steam engine. They're going to add a small switcher style steam engine, little tank engine. I think once they add that, they're going to have to add coal and water to all the different stations. Because a lot of times you're not going to take it from one town to the next, because I'm guessing it's not going to have much range on the coal and water. And it's probably not going to have a lot of speed either. So they really need to let you manually service it at every station. At least all the big cities, anyway. I can understand, like, maybe the oil well places not having coal and water, but all of the big cities really should, or at least water. Maybe just some of the places just add water and no coal. I would be okay with that, because coal lasts a long time. It's the water that you always run out of. There's the special stage. Okay, we're losing steam now. Not that it matters too much just yet. I don't know why it bothered coming over to this side. View's just as bad. There's still a giant tender to try to peek around. I still love my steam engine, though. I was going slow enough, I hope, to not do damage. I got there a little quicker than I thought I was going to. I was going pretty slow, though. I'm sure it was under 10. Good rule of thumb is as long as you're under 10 when you couple, you're not going to do any damage. There it is. Wait, did I leave the angle cock open on the freaking caboose back here? I did. Hear it? Who left the air open? I did. Habit. Bad habit. Good. At least I caught it. The steam engine doesn't have a little alarm inside telling you that you left it open, so the diesels do, but not the steamer. So that could have been a perplexing thing. Why won't the brakes release? Sort of the root is showing on that. Oh, that's bad. You gotta get that fixed. Because it's gonna go from being okay to not being okay quick. Have it pulled? Or you want to try to do a root canal? Yeah, that's a lot. Yeah. Aren't you in Canada? Right. That makes sense. Because dental's not covered, huh? Ah. Yep. Pretty close to the same kind of thing here. I'm on Medicaid, and that does cover dental, but usually people that are working and have insurance, a lot of times they don't have dental. It sucks. Or you have to buy dental insurance, and it's really freaking expensive. Right, yep. We'll just, you know... Tell them some bikers hit you with a crowbar or something and you just healed really well. But the tooth still needs to be fixed. I don't know. Don't do that. That's a horrible idea. Oh, you stopped? Yes. Listen, you heal really, really well. Why did this stop? Did it stop because it fell over? Or is that it for the tape already? That was it for the tape. I can't see. I need to add more to this tape. That was silly. This tape is very short. It's only Sonic 1, I guess. That might be one of the first ones that I made. Let's try this. Might I stop here? Don't I have my train? Alright, I gotta back up. I gotta go back up until I'm on the wind up for the loading track. I don't know why I stopped there. I'm doing good tonight. Today. Whatever this is. Now see, I've got a train behind me now, so there's really not much of a sense using the reverse headlight right now, because it just lights into the train cars. So I just might as well keep it on the headlight, I guess. Hi there, 4x4, how you doing? Okay. So I don't know what track they're going to want me to go on yet. There's two options. There's one and two here. So I might as... But I've got myself set up so that I just have to put her in forward and park on the right track to start loading up. Might as well put her in forward now. I gotta turn my fan on, it's getting warm. Hey, the sun's gonna come up soon, I think. Hey! What does this music sound like? It sounds like it... Well, it sounds like a Sega Genesis game. Something fell somewhere. I don't know what. Oh, actually, since we're not playing the radio, I can put down the antenna. Okay. Food factory to goods factory. Load up on B1. Not bad. That's B&O. Is all the way right, so I think we're good. Believe it or not, that's about as fast as I want to go through here. These faster cars. Maybe a little bit faster. Okay. Thankfully, I'm not using the stupid slideshow over the stream. So, you guys have seen the gameplay of everything that I've been doing. Why are the pastures not loading? There they go. But the bottom of the stream still says stream starting soon. I just looked over. And yeah, it still says that. The banner's not there. There we go. Okay, at least I didn't have anything covering up the gameplay, though. Okay, that bell ringing means that the pastures are loaded. It's time to go. Now we're just going from food factory here to the goods factory, which is a pretty short run. It's worth a decent amount of money, I think. I'm gonna go with that. Now we unload. Yeah, there's only one loading track there. Okay. I know what I'm doing. Now this music's interesting. I didn't even turn it up a notch. I completely missed that crossing. I was too busy turning the volume of the radio up. Oops. Tell that to the FRA. I was just turning the radio up, boss. I didn't see the crossing, I'm sorry. Got 3. You see that 1.5% grade going up, which is pretty steep. I want to go much more than like 25 on this curve, I think. Is that a belt buckle? Turnbuckle? Toes. No, not belt buckle. Oh, the thing that goes in the shoe and stretches it out? Okay. Never knew that had a name before. Right, okay, yep. Yeah, that would do it. I get it now. Right. My grandpa used to have to wear fancy dress shoes. And he had, it wasn't a bolt. But he had, like, this metal thing. It looked like a clamp with a hinge on it, and then you could adjust it to a different length and clamp it down to stretch out the shoe. Oh, toes, I know what you mean, because you wear those goofy toe shoes, don't you? I remember now. Yeah. I mean, I say goofy, but I wouldn't know unless I tried to wear one. Mm-hmm. So it's like your bare feet, but you have shoes. It's a neat idea. Wow, this is really steep. If I was actually hauling something heavy and not paying attention, then I would be in trouble right now, but these are just faster cars, so it's okay. And I want to go slow anyway on these curves. They feel goofy at first, okay. But then you get used to them. Alright. If I need to do something that I need more than just sandals for, which is kind of rare nowadays, mostly in the winter time when I'm snow blowing and stuff, then I just wear my steel toe boots. I finally got a new pair for this winter because my old boots, they still fit and everything, but the soles got so smooth that I slipped and fell in the driveway just on plain snow. It wasn't even ice. So I was like, okay. Yeah, that makes sense. I'll take the stance of don't knock it till you try it. It seems like a goofy thing, but it is a solid idea. It's like you're wearing shoes, but you're still got the same advantages of being barefoot. Right. Boots with no angle, yeah, that would be nice. I got into steel toe boots back when I started, when I worked on the railroad for that 1 year. Actually, the boots that I slipped and fell in over the winter that I finally stopped using, they're in a box down in the basement now. Those are the boots that I bought for working on the railroad, and I worked on the railroad in 2006 to 2007, so yeah, that's how long a pair of Eric boots lasts for me. That's because the last, like, I don't know how many years, I haven't even really had to use the boots that often because I don't do much that I need boots for. I've thought of getting sneakers, but honestly, I just either, if I'm just around the house, putzing around, whatever, the sandals are good enough, then if I need something better than sandals, I'll just put on the steel-toe boots. So used to them. I know the speed limit just went up to 6, but I gotta wait for the whole train to get past that sign. Special boots for those, for that. Keep your eyes peeled for a speed reduction sign now. I'm going a little bit slower anyway. So it won't be long before I'm at that switch. Make the turn. Wait, I made the turn already? I didn't even notice that I made that turn. That's why I was in a 6 downhill. Wow. I'm glad the switch was thrown because I never saw it. Oops. I'm playing kind of recklessly today. Because I haven't played in a while. fast. Now coming up, got the switch for oil well, which I'm sure that's not going to be switched, I'm pretty sure. I don't usually do much in the oil well. But then the switch for goods factory, I think I'm going to have to turn that. Yeah, we're good on the switch. So I want to slow down a little bit more because we got the faster cars. That should be slow enough. Technically, you're supposed to be able to do 6 in this zone, 60. But with these passenger cars, I don't trust it. Of course, I could alleviate that by getting the mod that shortens the passenger cars. They don't derail too badly. But I like the long ones. They look so good. The skins all work on the long ones. So I just gotta really make myself slow down all over the switches, mostly. It's the length that makes them derail, apparently. Weight-wise, they're pretty lightweight, but they're so long, for some reason this game just doesn't handle the long cars that well. Not yet, anyway. Alright, yeah, we need to go left. Alright. Or is this still oil? Oh, this is good. So there's a mod out there that cuts the length of the passenger cars down. And then the mod that gives you jobs for the passenger cars works with that. So, like, with the long cars, if the job is 5 cars, with the short cars, it'll be like, I don't know, 7. Maybe 8 cars. I'm not sure how short it makes them. But I did see some people were having some issues with the short cars. I don't remember what the issues were because I never had the short car mod, so I didn't worry about it. But everything mods you gotta take with a grain of salt. The end of the tape. It lasted a little longer than I thought it was when the first track was so short, but 8. Got a little ways to go. I'm gonna do something stupid. I'm gonna switch. And how fast are we going? 40. Oh, yeah, we're fine. Well, whatever this is, I'm playing it. Oh, this is Final Fantasy VIII. Okay. Well, not overpass, but the bridge that we cross under. That's the main line that goes up to military base and coal mine and iron mine east. That's fast enough. Of course, this is uphill here. That's wrong. All right, we're here. Everybody off. We gotta park it over on the empty track. Now, would normally pull forward and then back into the siding, but I have derailed on that curve since it's so freaking tight with these passenger cars, so I'm gonna back up so they can pull straight into that siding. Takes maybe a tiny bit longer? Not even, actually. But I'm avoiding that curve. I forgot to set my stopwatch, by the way. I was gonna set it, and especially with the passenger cars, it's really important to get there on time, or else you lose a lot of money. But whatever, I couldn't have really done this much faster than I did it anyway, so should be fine. Oh, I have to back all the way through the tunnel. Yeah. Getting myself turned around with this thing. I was gonna set up the wheel, but I don't know. I didn't really feel like setting up the wheel, and I had a feeling I was like, you know, if I set up this wheel, my nephew's gonna call me on Discord and be like, we gotta play Raft now. Then I just have to take the wheel back down. Oh, how fast are we going? Oh, we're only doing 20. That should be okay. If we derail at 20, I'm going to be a little upset. This is downhill, though. So I'll throw a little brake on. So now, of course, since I didn't set the wheel up, he's not going to call me. I don't even know if he's at my sister's house now, so that would give me a pretty big clue as to whether or not he's going to call. He has learned how to use Discord. Boy, trust me, he really knows how to use Discord. Like, if I'm not at the computer at the time, usually because I'm sleeping, he'll just call over and over and over again, and then, you know, hours later when I check Discord, it's like, you missed a call that lasted a few seconds, and there's like six of them in a row, and I'm like, okay. Listen, child, if you didn't get the hint the first time... Keeps you from derailing. Just not going around that stupid little curve. That switch thrown right. Next one's not, but the first one is. Wish I had even the smaller shovel right now, so I could put just a tiny bit of coal in. I think there is a smaller shovel, too. Oh, crap. That's it. Did I screw my... I think we're okay. Thought I waited too long to throw the switch, but we're okay. That could have been bad. Get in the engine. If I threw that switch after the front wheels were already over it, then we would have done some multi-track drifting. Which is hilarious, as that would be cost you a lot of money in repair bills. I've done it with the shunter a couple of times because I was trying to throw a switch further ahead, but for some reason the remote, this thing threw the switch that I was on top of instead, and oh boy, whole train just. Did I overcook it? Actually, these four cars, five cars, they just barely fit on the siding. I think that'll take that. Okay, they gave us 28 minutes. Oh boy, we did it in 24. Yeah, I took it a little bit slower than I needed to. Than I should have, I mean. But we made it. Total of 13,000. See how much more the time bonus is? Time bonus is an extra almost 9,000. So if you don't make it on time, it's really not worth it to haul passengers. At least the express trains. Okay. So we're in Goods Factory now. Let me, before I even think about what I'm going to do here, let me see how much water we have. I feel like I might have used a little bit more water than I wanted to. Well, 1, 2, 3, 4. And there's 9 total notches, so is it halfway? 4 and 4 is 8. Not even halfway. That's pretty good. Yeah, I didn't use too much water then. Still a decent amount of coal in here too. Okay, so let's see what we got. So on this next run, I want to either deliver to somewhere that has water, or through somewhere that has water. Let's see what these jobs are like. Machine factory from here. That's probably not too good. I could go up this way. You'd probably go this way. I think this way would be faster. Then you could stop a steel mill and fill up. Around it's a machine factory. Okay, so that's an option. 12,000. Another 5. City Southwest. Ooh, 10,000 for City Southwest. And that's on the way to machine factory. It's actually... Ah, come on. It's actually pretty good. Really? See, I could place it with this, but then it would always lay it flat, and I don't want it to lay flat. I want it to be angled a bit there. Switching, unload something for 2,800. That's not worth it. Ooh, just 13,000 to the harbor. 2,500 to harbor, which isn't much, but load and prepare something for harbor. It's probably not worth much. It's only 4 cars, but it's something. And then there's a passenger train to the harbor. Now, if I do the passenger train, I'm not going to do anything else. That would be 12 plus 6. That's what, 18,000? And what are these to harbor? 13. 2,500. So that has a potential to make more money to harbor than this. Of course, keep in mind I have to stop at steel mill and get more water. So, oh boy, and I'm coming from here. In order to stop at steel mill and get more water, I'd have to park on the main line, then run the engine back around. And that's assuming that I can.
Or actually, no, what I would do is I would just stop on the main line before the switch for the servicing. And just park. I'd just have to park the cars on a hill. I could do that. Game doesn't really care too much when you park something on a hill. Yeah, the switch goes this way. Yeah. Actually, technically, you could just pull the whole train right into the service depot from this end. Wait, which way? Steel mill coming from the north. Yeah, you could pull the train straight in if you wanted to. It's a very tight curve, though. I wouldn't do that with passengers. I would probably do it with freight, but not passengers. You still got to deal with the hill, though. So that's an option. This has probably a lot more potential here. This would be 10 plus 12 plus 5. How much is the weight? Let's see. 174, 5. That's 800. Oh, that's over 800 tons. That's probably just under 1,000 tons, isn't it? Which is really the limit with the steam engine. But from here, like, there is this hill going up to steel mill. So if I did that load, these three trains to put together. By the way, there's no switching jobs here. That's interesting. No, there is. There's two little switching jobs, but not worth it. But anyway, if I do that with that almost 1,000-ton train, I am not going to want to park the train back here on this freaking hill to get serviced. Because I will not get it started again. I'm going to have to pull straight all the way through, park on the main line, and hope that there's an empty track in the yard so that I can run around and get to the service track. But then from the steel mill, we're going this way, which is downhill. Like, if we were going this way to Harbor, it would be all up, and that would be tricky, but this is down. And then it's up from City Southwest up to Machine Factory, although we would be shedding off almost 400 tons in City Southwest, so that's very doable. It is very doable. It's just that service stop in the steel mill is going to be a pain in the ass. Got to do it, though, because for some reason you can't get coal and water in Machine Factory, even though it's a freaking machine factory, and it's got a big turntable and roundhouse, and there's always, a lot of times, a steam engine spawns there. You can't get coal and water there. It doesn't make any sense. It's really designed so that you can only use the steam engine on certain routes, like the different mines to the steel mill, to the harbor, and just go back and forth between those places. I don't like the steam engine being that limited, because I love using the steam engine. It's the thing. I didn't bring the radio with me. We're not listening to any music. That's horrible. It's raining. Alright, I gotta just make a decision here. So I don't know if anybody cares, but we have the option of taking a train. We have the option of taking a couple of freight sets to the harbor in town, which is going to amount to about 15,000, plus whatever bonus we get for getting there on time. We can take just this passenger set to the harbor, and that's going to amount to 18,000 if we make it there on time. So a little bit more. But it's very important to get this one there on time. These two, it doesn't make as, it's not as important. Or we can do the City Southwest and Machine Factory combo for 28,000. That's money wise, that's the best one. It's just that stop at steel mill, it's going to be kind of a pain. So I'll let you guys think on that. I'll just play this for a minute, so you have something to listen to. And I'll be right back. And so if anybody's got anything, thing they want me to do, just let me know. Otherwise, I'm probably going to try that City Southwest Machine Factory thing. I should probably turn my camera off. Good old kids. Hi, Ava. Come play Classic. Oh, that's WoW. I'm thinking about it. I'm really tempted. Of course, I have to buy WoW time for Classic. I can't get away with just playing on, like, starter account status. That's interesting. In OBS, your name is one color, and on my pop-out chat, it's a different one. I tried playing Classic a couple months ago, and it's obviously part of the marketing. Like, it lets you go into the switch in Battle.net. You got to switch it to Classic, and then you can pick a server. And I noticed in Classic there's still PvP servers. And then when you go to make a character. Oh no! You can't make a character in starter. You have to upgrade. You have to buy time, and it's like you couldn't tell me first. You had to let me try. But of course, that's just another way to get you to spend money. I might do it. I might do it soon. Yeah, they almost got me. It is really tempting. Classic, now you can tell me, does Classic have Burning Crusade now? I think I heard it does, like it goes into Outlands. Which is neat, but at the same time it's a little bit funny because it's like, oh, okay. Well, Classic is just going to be another version of the same game. PC is launching this Tuesday. Oh, neat. So it's going to be like the very beginning of Burning Crusade. Okay. See, Burning Crusade is so old, I kind of consider it vanilla. Oh, okay. I guess best for Classic eventually would be vanilla plus Burning Crusade plus... I would even go to Wrath of Lich King. That expansion was really good too. But stop there. No Classic Kata. Kata ain't freaking Classic. That's the new thing that screwed everything up. Yeah. Although, I guess if they make it optional, like you're saying, you can stay in Vanilla or you could go to Burning Crusades. That who knows what they'll do. I remember years and years ago, people were saying that they were just going to make a WoW 2, you know, WoW sequel, and then the original WoW would die off, but that never happened. It wouldn't make much sense to do that. I guess that's what they did with EverQuest, though, right? There's an EverQuest and an EverQuest 2. But, I think, eeny, meeny, miny, mo, I think I'm going to try to put this big freight train together. Nice. Friends, we made our own way. Yes. I've been thinking about WoW a lot. Then I randomly think about Shay, and I'm like, oh man. The feels. These are all loaded, huh? It's gonna be a big train. Alright, let's try it out. Yell at me if the music's too loud. The song is kind of loud. Oh, this is still... You can't have both. Oh, you can't. Ah, happened. Just trying to go back. No? It's freaking picking up the whole boombox. I'm just trying to hit the buttons. Come on. So I have to play. There we go. I don't know if you guys want to listen to just Final Fantasy music or everything. I think I'll just leave it on the groove thing. It's just easier to deal with than switching tapes on the boombox. So since you've been current with WoW, Avo, did you like, what was the newest expansion? Shadowlands isn't out yet, the one before that, the Alliance versus Horde one. Battle for Azeroth. I heard from a lot of different, like, sources, let's say, that one wasn't too good. I wouldn't know, because I haven't played since Draenor was new. I haven't even done any Draenor zones. Now, last time I played the Demon Hunter expansion was pretty new. BFO, it was okay. Yeah, that's kind of what I figured. It's my understanding that lore wise, Battle for Azeroth was like bringing back all the PvP stuff that, like, the game wasn't as strong as in PvP. Raids and dungeons, so it was great, but not much to do outside. Oh, okay. I want to see Draenor someday. I'm interested because Draenor is like Outlands before it became fractured and Outlands, like when it was still a planet. So, like, seeing Kul Tiras not destroyed and seeing Terrakar Forest, that kind of thing would be neat. Questing in Draenor is amazing. Cool. Yeah, I am starting to get the WoW bug. Oh, okay. Oh yeah, Shattera and Hellfire. Yep. Ah yes, Hellfire before it became Hellfire. Headlights are on, right? Yeah. Since it's raining. Oh, I need coal. Probably after the stream. Oh, it's 7 o'clock? Good lord. I just lost like 2 hours of time. Probably after the stream and after I eat dinner and stuff, I might check out WoW. That's around. Shadowlands is out. Okay. I ain't gonna be buying that anytime soon. Maybe now that Shadowlands is out, they'll give me the Demon Hunter one for free expansion. I don't remember what expansion was new at the time, but I remember logging in after I hadn't played for a while, and they just gave me Draenor. Oh, Legion is already free. See? They are all just logging in and just pick up Legion. Nice. Listen, I don't play the expansions until they're 2 expansions old. Oh, wow. Nice. Let's see, I guess you would call me a hipster, huh? It's not cool until it's old. Isn't that what hipsters do? I don't know internet terms. Okay, that's closed. I don't know why I didn't get any air blast there, but... it's open. It's open. Okay. I'll go around the loop. Included in the base game, right? As it should be, really. They can't expect new players to buy like 5 expansions along with the game. I was going through some papers in my drawer of the desk the other day. I was looking for a paper with the model number of the air conditioner downstairs written on it, because I'm sure I wrote it down before. Because I need to find a replacement remote for it. But anyway, when I was looking through there, I was finding like all sorts of old notes, because I never throw anything out. And one list was like how to make the, I forget what armor set. The one that you make with thorium. That's Imperial set, I think. One of the big, like, important sets that you would make with blacksmithing. Basically, one of the reasons to get blacksmithing was to make this set, because at one time, years and years ago, of course, that was a really important set to make for, like, warriors, or probably protection paladins, too. I think probably more towards Ret Pally, though. It was more of a DPS plate set. But it looked just like the Stormwind guards, the armor. And it took a ton of thorium and whatever gem goes around with thorium. I forget what gem it is. It's a yellow one. Starts with an A. But anyway, I saw that list and I was like, oh wow. All my years of blacksmithing. And then I saw a list for different armor that I was going to build for one of Shay's characters, and I was like, oh lord. And the other guys that I played with on Alliance all the time, and I was like, oh. And I even had some passwords written down because they would let me play on their accounts. It's like, okay. Memory lane. I don't want to play WoW. Okay, let's figure out where these are. Now, these are all loads, so I don't have to put them in any special order. Just gonna need to get the three sets together. I think it was Shay's paladin that I was making gear for. Traista? Yeah, I think that was how it was pronounced. Let's see, O1. Okay, here's O1. 38. I see 15. Nope. Yes, that's a Verde. It's the priest. 38. Okay. 21. Okay, so these three sets are all right next to each other. That makes things a little easier. Wait, are these all... Oh, wait a minute. One of them's going to city southwest, right? I want the city southwest in the front. 21. This set goes in the front, so I gotta take these two and put them on the back. Okay. Oh, Verdolinia would have been my main on Horde. That's my pally. She's... Verdolinia on Horde is my level 90 pally. And on Alliance is Raber. He's my other level 90. They're the only two that I bothered to get up to 90, even. Of course, whatever level that translates to now, because it's all been knocked in half, so I guess 45 now? Yes, dwarf. That was my first character, River. And Raver was the name of my dwarf that I played in Dungeons & Dragons before I even knew about World of Warcraft. And the tie-in with that is when I went on to do LARPing with my same friends that I did D&D with. I was a dwarf and everybody else were elves. And apparently the elves didn't like pronouncing Raver very much, so they renamed me Red Bear. So there's the origin of my name. Red Bear, because the elves didn't understand Raber. Well, that didn't work. Oops. I meant to get in between and do something fancy with the lever there. But it didn't work at all. I just glitched through the car. Oh. No. Since these cars are all spawned in after I updated the handbrake mod, let me just make sure there's no handbrakes on. Yeah. I don't think there will be. Stupid elves, yeah. Yeah. It was kind of a funny group dynamic because I think pretty much everybody in our group were Kirigani elves, which are, I guess the equivalent in WoW would be night elves. They're like tribal, almost American Indian like. Did I leave something open? The air is hooked up. Not that long of a train, is it? Shouldn't be open on the other end. These are just spawned in. Why is it open here? I have never seen freshly spawned in cars like these are have the angle cock open on the wrong end. On any end, really. They always default to being closed. That was weird. Huh. That was very strange. It's 38. Okay. Weird. That's the set that I want on, so I hook up to this one next. Okay. I hope I have enough room to run around. I don't know. This is a long train. Trying to put together. Yeah, they were all Kirigani elves, and I was a dwarf. We had to, I don't remember what the real explanation was, but we had to come up with a story of why this lone dwarf, red-bearded dwarf, would even think about working together with these elves. Because, I mean, they're not like hated races or anything like that, but they don't usually get along all that great. And I was looking at some of my my characters in WoW on server. Jesus, this is how long it's been since I played, well, Shadow Council server. You know, Lords of Defiance. And some of them actually were wearing guild tabards. And what do you know? They're blank. I do believe I've been booted from ye old Lords of Defiance. I mean, I can't blame them. I haven't played in years. But still, I don't think anybody else in that guild has really played in years either. I don't know. I don't know if Z still plays at all. Yeah. I don't think so. Maybe once in a blue moon. They probably just went through and anybody that hadn't played in multiple years, they're like, yeah, let's kick them out. Die, Sturgy. I'm down. It's okay. Bored, I'm guessing. Which set am I taking next? This one. Yeah. Ooh, what? I'm just talking about World of Warcraft memories. Oh, you, I'm guessing. With the repetitive words. Yeah, I know, I'm just switching cars around right now. It is kind of boring. Derailed, I see what you... I don't mind. I talk about whatever when I play this, because really there's only so much I can talk about with the trains. Already explained everything a few times, so... You are showing me how much I missed it. I don't know if I would ever stream WoW, even if I get back into it, which is going to be a problem, because then I'm trying to get myself to stream more, and then if I start playing WoW a lot, it's not really that great of a game to stream, per se. There's a lot of just kind of exploring and questing and whatnot. I don't know how good of content that would be, and I need to get myself back into streaming more. Haven't streamed in, God, like a week and a half now. Which is bad, because I need to be streaming consistently and getting more viewers and stuff, and like, maybe make a buck or two. But, I don't think that's ever gonna happen. I am very appreciative of anybody who decides to support me, so. I should mention that more often. I don't know how many more burst badges are up for grabs. I know Sturgy's got one, and I think maybe there might be two more left. It's the first 10 subscribers get that badge. Two or three more left, I think. That's about it. Ah, we're getting heavy. So, how's everybody doing? I should be asking that every once in a while. I'm probably gonna get this train together. 7:15 now. I think I'm probably gonna get this train together and call it a stream, actually. Not that long of a stream. I didn't start quite as early as I wanted to, but it will be dinner time sometime soon-ish, I think. And it's just kind of silly to keep the stream going and muted while I eat or something like that, so. Maybe if nobody's streaming a bit later after I'm done eating, maybe I'll stream again. If I do stream again, it'll probably be Minecraft. You know, it's funny, I remember years ago there were some people in WoW. Friends of my friend Galesta, I think. That weren't playing WoW anymore. Probably around the time the Kata came out or something like that. You know, a lot of people stopped playing WoW around Kata. And I remember her telling me that they stopped playing WoW because they just played Minecraft instead. And we all thought how crazy an idea that was. We were like, what? They're playing Minecraft instead of World of Warcraft? What? And then, you know, eventually I got into Minecraft more and more, and I'm like, yeah, okay, I can see that happening, and I need to back up more. 1, 2, 3, a little over 3 cars. World of Minecraft. Yeah, and then I'm like, oh, I see the appeal. Because I'm guessing back then I was just starting to get into Minecraft. And the longest time with Minecraft, I only played solo. I never tried to play multiplayer or anything. And I just had the one single Minecraft world. And I still have that as my main vanilla world. Of course, I got into mods and I have all of that stuff going now too. I do have another vanilla world besides that. But lately, what am I back into with Minecraft? My original freaking world that I started. God, I don't know how many years ago. Version 1.4.7. Oh my god, I didn't back up enough. I thought I backed up too much. I still have to go back a quarter car. Come on. Nice. Well, do you get that urge in playing Minecraft in survival? Is the question. Because I can see that in creative. I don't really play creative at all. Very rarely. Because it's just not fun if you don't have to grind for the materials, I guess. Yeah. Yeah, I can see that. I do have one world that I played in creative a lot with my mods. And it was mostly because I'm testing out a newer version of Rails of War mod. So, and that mod really only works in creative now, as it stands. And I did have fun in creative with that. But I guess I like it, but I would get bored with it. I guess. Where with survival, you kind of go through a cycle where you have to go mining and getting materials, and then you have to go around and really plan out the route that you're going to run a railroad in and stuff like that. And then you build. And you get to do a lot of building, which is like the reward. Almost. Then you run out of materials and you're back to farming. I can't see. I'm realizing that I cannot see the leading end of this freaking train at all. But now I'm coupling this big long train to another long set. Hold on. I need to just ride this end and coast slowly, I think. Wait a minute. We going the right way?
Yeah.
Actually, slow her down. Oh, I was going slow enough anyway. I was getting a little worried. So I was a lot closer than I thought I was. Okay, let me let the air build back up. I guess my light would help, wouldn't it? But what is that? Four cars? This is really where multiplayer would help. You'd have one person down here saying, okay, bring her forward four more cars. And then the other person in the engine shoving her forward four more cars. But someday. So I gotta start going around that bend. We'll just go real slow and keep going until we feel it. Actually, that might be enough to roll. Yeah, we'll roll it in. Oh, yeah. This is working. Yep. That's how you do that. I will just make sure all the handbrakes are off. It should be. I guess I better check that angle cock again. Oh, okay. Alright, now we need to shove this in enough that I can get the engine around it. Hopefully. Fit. What's the longest track? Well, this one's pretty long. I just need to get past this point here. So, 1, 2, 3, 4 cars plus a little. Oh, but I don't need to count cars. I'll just watch the caboose. Am I doing? Think it'll fit. Hope it'll fit. If not, I'm not quite sure I'm going to get the engine on the right end of this train. Alright, I'll see ya. I might get on WoW tonight, but I don't think I'll be buying WoW time, though. But we could poke messages at each other on Battle.net if we want to. I can squeeze by that. Oh, I definitely could if I go around that way. Okay. I could go around that track. Oh, I still got plenty of room. Okay, good. Go forward a little bit more then.
Yeah, do you guys?
Okay, that should be fine. Close the angle pack. There we go. We'll just go up this track. And this... Oh, no, not this track. This track. My bear can't see. D4. Yeah. Plenty of room. Almost not really a point in switching the headlight, just for this little move backwards, but why no move? Whoa. Did I not uncouple? I did not. Did the air, I didn't unhook the chain. Oops. Like, why no move? That's why no move. You've cut 1,000 tons of train with the brakes locked down. Yeah, you're not gonna move. Oh yeah, it's a good thing I put the reverse light on. It is a safety thing though. Whenever you make a reverse move, you gotta have the headlight on that end, so that other people can see you, at the cars and whatnot. People on the ground. No, you're not getting more coal yet. We're just moving the engine around now. You can have more water. You can always have more water. Oh god. Did I not throw the switch? Chat, why didn't I throw the switch? I've been bumbling around the railroad all the livelong day. I almost crashed the train. To make the content stay. I don't know. Listen, not good at improv. I think I threw a switch, but not the right one. That switch. Well, let me get out and make sure everything's right this time. That switch and that. Yeah, I think I threw this switch, but I didn't throw this one. Okay, well, that was fun. Now, if anybody's wondering why I didn't start by putting the caboose at the end of an empty track and just building the train from the back to the front, I guess my answer to that would be because I didn't have to. I built it this way. I put the caboose at that end, because now I'm going to put the locomotive at the front end here. The disadvantage, the advantage was it was a little bit easier in the switching side of things here. The disadvantage now is now I got to back the whole thing, or, well, not all the way around the loop, but back enough to throw the switch for the diagonal reverse loop through. But since I know the track is going to be all clear anyway, it's not that big a deal. Because if you don't need to see the back end of the train when you're doing a reverse move, then it's not that big a deal. But if you do need to see the back end of the train, then it's that you're in trouble. Right up to the bumper. Stop. Thank you. Now I will put the backlight on. Oh. This is a little laggy. Yeah, it's got a little too many mods. It probably got a little bit too many skins. The skins do add more lag. Okay. This is my train, right? Should be. Yeah, it's not the right. It's not lined up good, so yeah, this is it. Now, FH21. Yes, I did this right. As I was pulling the engine forward here, I had a little bit of a weird fear in the back of my head that I didn't put those cars where I wanted them to be, but I did. I did it right. That first set of containers goes to City Southwest, and then the rest of the train goes to Machine Factory. Alright. Cool. Boy, if I do get WoW and go the classic route, I really would like it because, man, it's going to be so nostalgic. It's going to be like starting up back in the day, but at the same time, oh man, I might miss some things from modern WoW. First off, with WoW Classic, let's see if... Whoa, that switch was thrown the wrong way. Didn't I look at the switches and say everything was right? I missed this one. This one wasn't right. Yep, that's wrong. But let's see if WoW Classic has Burning Crusades. I'm just trying to think of when you get what mount. Like a modern day WoW, it's pretty silly, because you get your first mount at level 20, which way back in very early WoW, you didn't get your first mount until level 40. I think with Burning Crusades, is it still 40? I think it'll be 30, which makes a little bit more sense. 40 is a little too late to get your first mount, because I remember... Of course, you didn't have to do it this way, but when I played my dwarves, I would always, at around level 30, I would go way over, not to Tenaris, but I guess it was Thousand Needles. It was just north of Tanaris, yeah. The area with the, I'm talking about this stuff like anybody knows anything about WoW. But the area with, the goblins and the racetrack. It's all underwater now with after the cataclysm. But it used to be like a wacky racetrack and, I don't know why I always went there at level 30-ish, because there was a quest from Ironforge to deliver crash helmets to that racetrack. I guess that's why I went there. But for Alliance, there's like a couple of quest chains out there in Thousand Needles, and that's it. And so you do a few quests there, and then they'd be done, and there wouldn't be anything else in Thousand Needles. Thousand Needles is technically contested zone, but it was much more Horde than Alliance back then. So you do those few quests, and then there wasn't really anything else to do, and it was still a little... I think if I was playing a Pally or something that was a little overpowered, then I could get away with starting Tanaris. But Tanaris was like 45 almost. I think 40, 45. So, I don't know why I always went there at level 30, because then I'd always end up having to go somewhere else anyway. But my point is, back then, why am I putting it forward or in reverse? Back then, you didn't have a mount yet at level 30, so in order to get to Thousand Needles for Alliance, oh boy. You had to go to, like, Ratchet. So you had to run down through Stranglethorn Keep if you didn't have that yet. And then you had to go over to Ratchet from Booty Bay. And run down through the Barrens. And run all the way across Thousand Needles. On foot, because you didn't have a mount yet. What am I going to do if I get WoW Classic pretty soon and start playing it? I'll probably do the same stupid thing. I'm like, oh, I'm level 30. It's time. There's this quest from Ironforge. It's time to go to freaking Thousand Needles and traverse both continents on foot. There's really no need to do that. There's plenty of other Alliance zones that are a lot closer. Oh, it'll be nice to see the places that are destroyed now after Cataclysm be not destroyed. Alright, so we've got our whole train together. It is 7:30. Probably gonna be dinner time soon anyway. I think I'm gonna stop it here. Sorry for all the WoW talk, but I don't know, I always feel like I gotta talk about something, and I love playing Derail Valley. I get plenty of fun out of it, but there's not a whole lot to talk about with Derail Valley. I kind of just talk about the same things with it, so. If there's another subject to talk about instead, I'll end up doing that. But anyway, thanks for dealing with me, I guess, for a few hours, and I'll see you guys around later. I don't know when later is going to be. It might even be tonight if nobody else is streaming, and I get the urge, if I'm awake. If it's not tonight, though, it should be pretty soon. Pretty soon. Maybe tomorrow I'll set up my wheel. All right. I'll see you then. Later. Oh, was paused.